Can a survey sonar kill or harm a marine mammal or fish? As a marine surveyor myself, I was quite unaware of this.
But as I looked deep in many research papers, I started to understand the impact we humans are causing to the vast array of marine life. You see, oceans are full of noise. Some are anthropogenic, some are biologic, and some are natural. Natural sounds are like ambient low frequency noise ranging from 1 Hz to 200 Hz. Biologics are mainly sounds marine mammals and fishes communicating and echolocating. Marine mammals normally communicate in the range from as low as 10 Hz to as high as 24,000 Hz or 24 kHz. But for echolocation and long distance communication, these marine mammals can produce sounds which are up to 110 kHz. Now, these anthropogenic sounds are entirely man-made sound. Anything from ships and boats' propeller noise, cavitation, to the use of active sonar, seismic survey, and high-frequency sonars for ocean bottom survey. These everyday man-made sounds can range from 1 Hz to 100 kHz. And they completely envelop almost every kinds of biologic sounds made by marine mammals. The dominant noise source is usually propeller cavitation, which has peak power near 50 to 150 Hz, but also radiates broadband power at higher frequencies, at least up to 100 kHz. But it's not only the frequency, but the loudness of the noise, which can go up to 190 decibels, does the most harm. For reference, the noise of the jet engine taking off is just 140 decibels. So how does the human-generated anthropogenic sound affect the marine mammals? This has now become a topic of increasing controversy, especially regarding marine mammals. Reports have also shown that underwater ambient noise in the Northwest Pacific increased 3.3 decibel per year from 1950 to 2007, amounting to an increase of about 20 decibels. Sound travels much faster and farther underwater, which explains why marine noise pollution has been a big issue in recent years. The impact of low frequency, that is less than 1 kHz, such as shipping noise, and mid-frequency 1 to 10 kHz sources, such as naval sonar, on marine mammals are well documented. Not much research has been done on higher frequency sources, that is more than 10 kHz, such as ocean mapping multibeam echo sounder. Many reports suggest that anthropogenic sounds are responsible for less salmon migrating upriver. The feeding and breeding grounds of the marine mammals and fishes have changed drastically. Now, the progress of civilization cannot be stopped altogether. But we can be a little bit more vigilant, a little bit more sensitive towards those creatures with whom we share this world. Evolution will eventually have its way, and these marine mammals will find a way to steer clear of the humans, only if we do not wipe them out completely.